I'm really excited to talk about this. Been talking about this a lot. Been kind of looking at the list and free agency, obviously. And I've made my, I guess, five here. And this is, some of this is dream, and some of this is reality, okay? Some of this I could see seeing happen, some of this is just crap and dream stuff, okay? So obviously there's a lot of players like Eric Berry, you got Eric Berry, you got Le'Veon Bell. There's a lot of players that there's no crap in way, and this God's green earth that they're getting out of the building, okay? But, this is my top five free agents that if I was a Dolphins GM, I'd be looking into. Now, let's, to just pause that for 2 seconds, I want to, people, we have to re-sign really quick. First of all, we have to extend Rashard Jones. If we don't really extend Rashard Jones and we let him walk, I'm going to cry like a baby for at least weeks. Okay, when Charles Clay left, I was depressed for 2 months. Especially him going to the Bills, it hurt my heart. It was disgusting. Okay, two, we have to sign Kenny Stills. If we don't sign Kenny Stills, I'm liable to do anything. Illegally, it doesn't matter. I will hurt. Kenny Stills was such a big part of our season. He caught 9 touchdowns. I've heard rumors that we're trying to extend Jarvis. That doesn't really matter. I think we can wait to do that. If anything, we'll franchise tag him after his rookie contract runs out. That's, to me, down the road. I know some Dolphins fan wants to get that done now. If you want to get it done now, I could see us waiting or get it done now. I really don't care. Yeah. And I definitely want to at least look into re-evaluating. I can't really say re-instructing right now for some reason. Brandon Albert's contract. We have to do a little tweak that a little bit. And if I'm being honest, guys, we gotta get rid of Jermon Bushrod. I know a lot of people want to keep this offensive line together, continuity. No. Jermon Bushrod was inconsistent. He was very inconsistent. And I'm not having that at all. So yeah, if we don't re-sign Kenny Stills, that'll be the death of me. And if we don't re-sign, Andre Branch also. If we don't re-sign Andre Branch, I'm gonna cry. I will cry. Okay, it's not gonna be fun. I don't know. I'll go into a deep depression. I'll stop everything. I will not do anything anymore. But seriously, Kenny Stills is the most important thing of this offseason. I swear to God, if Mike Tannenbaum with his bald spot doesn't do any, I'm not even going to think about it anymore. So this is my top five list of people I would like to at least look into. So now the guard position is very interesting this year. Like I said, I would get rid of Jermon Bushrod. And a lot of people say, build it through the draft. Don't build it through free agency. I'm not saying we're going to build it through crap in free agency. Okay? And I hate saying crap in, but it's the only thing I can say. Alright, it's the tick, I apologize, but it's the only thing, this is, in my mind, the best solution to the problem, okay, because the guard position is deep as balls. Now, there are 3 guards that I really like, okay, TJ Lang's a little old for me, okay, he's a little old, but there are 3 guards that I like. Larry Warford, I don't know how you say his name, Kevin Zeitler, I think that's how you say him, or Zeitler, tell me in the comment section anyway. And number 3, Chance Warmack. Take your crap and pick. Okay, I think Kevin is 26. So he's very young. He's going to command a lot of money in free agency. I think he was second team all pro football focus. If we pick up him, he's going to cost a lot of money. And I understand that. But if I'm Chris Greer, that is one of the things I'm looking into. Okay, Kevin Zeitler. And even Larry Warford, I like both of them. Chance Warmack's a really good run blocker. I think you can take your pick from any one of those guys, in my opinion. I think they're better than Jermon Bushrod, that's for sure. I know Kevin's probably gonna, he's gonna re-sign with the Bengals. But I would definitely go, I don't know how you guys feel about that, but I definitely would cut Jermon Bushrod and go after one of the guards, for sure. I think that would be not my number one priority. And obviously, this is excluding re-signing, okay? This is just me talking about people we could get. And I know that a lot of people are like, I don't spend any money, and traditions of past and all this stuff, but we really, look what the Raiders did, okay? We really need a new guard, and I would love to get one of those guys, because it's very deep. The guard position is very deep in free agency this year. I don't know how you guys feel about TJ Lang. I think he's a little too old. Me, personally, think he's a little too old. But okay, so that's the guard position. That's my number one priority. Now, number 2. Now, this one's This one's like, I don't know. Like, I don't know. You know what I mean? I don't know if I want to do this because I don't want to pay him all this money and him be crap and trash. This guy's gonna command a lot of money. And I don't know if we should go after him. I don't know if we should get into the bidding war for him. I really don't even know if we should waste our time. So, yeah. I mean, this is just a dream. This is like a dream scenario thing. Trumaine Johnson. I love the way Tony Lippitt has came along. I love the way Xavier Howard has come along. I love the way that Byron Maxwell has come along. I love, and first of all, Tony Lippitt is not, he is not an inside corner, he is an outside corner. You can't, that's, maybe I could see that. I just don't see the quickness. I don't know. Tell me, I don't know how you guys feel about that. This is, I might even take this back, even thinking about it, because of development reasons, but Trumaine Johnson, to me, is a very, he's a lockdown number one corner in this league. They when they was with the Rams, they used a lot of man coverage with him. He did very well. I like Trumaine Johnson a lot. I've liked him for a long time. I've talked about Trumaine Johnson for years, even on this channel. I made one of my earliest videos was about Trumaine Johnson. So, I love Trumaine Johnson, basically. Now, I would love him to be a Dolphin. Now, there's another corner that I really like, and I'm going to share that with you guys right now. I don't know how you guys feel about this, but for me personally, I like this corner a little bit now. I think his name, if I'm getting the Houston Texans corner who had a really good year this year, I think his name is A.J. Boye. Now, I could be getting that wrong. I want to say, it's A.J. Boye. I think that's how you say his name. I really like this guy. Now, Stephon Gilmore is another guy that you could look at. I don't know. I think he'll stay a Bill. Maybe he's got a new coaching staff there. Maybe not. I like A.J. Boye more. And I think he's going to command less money. I don't know how the market's going to be. I don't know. He could command even, because cornerback's very, very valuable. But I love A.J. because you can move him inside, outside. He can play. He's very versatile. I actually might even like him more than I do Trumaine. Trumaine Johnson, I don't think, could play inside. I don't know. See, this is a hard one. I think A.J. Boye is going to cost less money, but Trumaine Johnson is the better corner, like, talent-wise. But A.J. Boye is a little bit more versatile, but Trumaine Johnson does his job, like, what he's really good at, better than what A.J. Boye does both ways, I think. I don't know how you guys feel about that. So I think we've done two so far. That would be my top two, guys. So the next three, right? Defensive end. Was a very big problem. Earl Mitchell is not a three-down guy. We've talked about this a long time. He's not a three-down guy. And obviously, Jordan Phillips is the most inconsistent. I don't know. I question his motor. I think he takes plays off sometimes. Vance Joseph really got upset at him about some of that kind of effort kind of thing. And he wanted to... Jordan Phillips makes great plays sometimes. He's just super inconsistent. So I do think this is a dream scenario now. Now, there are two really good defensive tackles, Brandon Williams and Dontari Poe. Now, both of these guys, we could pull... we have the most cap space in the AFC East, if I'm not mistaken. So, we have the cap. Now, this is just like... I'm not saying all of these guys are going to get signed in one offseason. I'm just saying these are what I would like to at least explore these adventures, right? So, Dontari Poe, I would love to at least explore that because they have two very big free agents. Eric Berry and Poe... They're going to have to choose between one of those guys, so obviously it's going to be Poe. Poe would be a very good guy next to Sue. Like, obviously he takes up a lot of space. He's a very good nose tackle. He's really hard to move. He's really good against the run. His best strength is against the run, and I think that's what we need. So I would love Poe, and the same goes for Brandon Williams. Such a good run stuffer. Both of these guys are extremely good at stuffing the run. I like both of those guys. If we got one of them for, I don't know, I don't know how much they're going to command. Nose tackles really don't command a lot of money. I don't know how much Damian Harrison or Snacks, you guys know what I'm talking about. Obviously, former Jet goes over the Giants. I don't know how much they paid him, but he's a very similar player. I like that. I don't know how you guys feel about that. If you guys, like, you want to go after... That's another thing we could address in the draft also. That's not that big of a deal, but I would love either one of those players to be on the team, basically. And I just think that's a huge need there, and we definitely need to look into it and do something in free agency about that. Maybe add competition, not a big name. Maybe somebody who we think's up-and-coming, see talent in. I don't know. I really don't know. Okay? But that is something we need to explore regardless, okay? So, the next guy, so defensive end, I don't know how you guys feel about this either, but Jason Pierre-Paul is going to be a free agent. And wherever he goes, he could become returned to the Giants. I doubt it. But I think he led the league when he was healthy, because before he got hurt, he led the league in quarterback pressures. He had more than Von Miller, which is extremely impressive. Now, again, this is not all in one season, but I would love to have him on the team. I think we're really missing, because both of our Andre Branch and Cameron Wake, not very good against the run. Cameron Wake, primarily good at pass. He's very great, but he's a great pass rusher. Not so much against the run. Excuse me. Same thing with Andre Branch. Great pass rusher, just not a great all-around defensive end. If we got JPP, he's a great all-around defensive end. He can wreck your game plan. He's going to command a lot of money. Obviously, he's a pass rusher. He's a very high-end pass rusher. They always command a lot of money. So that's a top-shelf guy. That's probably a far and few between dream. To finish it off, is obviously the linebacker position. Now, this is interesting, because we've talked about going to a 3-4. Now, hypothetically, this is a crazy dream that's never going to happen. There's so many good outside linebackers. If you go from Nick Perry to Melvin Ingram, there are so many good pass rushers in terms of a 3-4 linebacker. It's insane. But, I don't know. I guess we shouldn't talk about that. If we wanted to, though, if we really wanted to, we could do it. But, that would probably mean we wouldn't re-sign Kenny. So, yeah, no. I don't know. Yeah, we probably wouldn't be able to extend Rashard Jones either. So that's not something. It's not a road we're going to go down, because it's unrealistic. But my point is there's a lot of great linebackers out there. Dante Hightower, I know some of you are going to bring him up. I don't think he's not. I think he's going to be a Patriot. I don't think he's coming over here. Plus, Jamie Collins. I love Jamie Collins. Obviously, if you're a Dolphins fan, you've watched him for years terrorize the Dolphins. He's very versatile. He's a great pass rusher. He's a really good middle linebacker. He's big. He's strong. He moves people. I love Jamie Collins. I think the rumor, he's going to command a lot of money too. He's going to be a very, very high-end type of a player. But if he went, this is something we definitely need to explore. It's the weakest positional group on the football team. We definitely need to explore it at least. There's a lot of good linebackers. Jamie Collins would be a guy that I think we definitely, like I said, he's great. He's a great pass rusher, great run stuffer, great in coverage. He's a great coverage linebacker. Just to name some other guys, I don't believe some of these guys aren't going to leave. I think Lawrence Timmons, he's older. I think he's still going to be a Steeler. Zach Brown is another guy. Zach Brown's, I don't know how you guys feel about Zach Brown. I don't know. You can tell me. You guys can tell me. Malcolm Smith, he's Malcolm Smith, great coverage guy. But Jamie Collins, Jamie ever played? I know they played him sometimes in middle linebacker, but I'm pretty sure Jamie plays outside linebacker for the Browns, if I'm not mistaken. You guys quiz me on that. But he definitely can be a middle linebacker, for sure. We need to fix this crap in middle linebacker situation. Zach Brown is very good. I think he's very underrated. I like Zach Brown a lot. That could be that's totally fine with me if we win Zach Brown. I like Zach Brown a lot. Malcolm Smith is obviously very good. Both of these guys finished the season with 100 plus tackles. They're both 26, I think. They had 3.5 sacks, if I'm not mistaken. That could be wrong. I know they're all young though. So that's pretty good. I like Zach Brown. I don't think he'll command a lot of money. Jamie Collins, I still think is a great. I think he could still be a really good inside linebacker. But yeah, that's some. I would say Chandler Jones is over Jamie Collins in terms of a 4-3 defensive end, because we've seen him do it before with his hand in the dirt. But he's apparently going to be franchise tagged to the Cardinals, so that sucks. And then safety. If you guys want to go down this road, if you think we need a new safety, Eric Berry. Obviously, he's not leaving the building. You got Tony Jefferson, who had a really good year with Arizona. Jonathan Cyprian, don't like Jonathan Cyprian. Jahiel Adai had a really good season for the Cincinnati, for the Chargers, the LA Chargers now. Barry Church. Barry Church, can't really stay healthy. I don't know how you guys feel about Barry Church. I don't know if we should even go down the safety route. I don't think we need a safety that bad. I don't think we need a safety at all, to be honest with you guys. Defensive tackle, if you guys were wondering, K'Juan Short is the by far, he's one of the best. You could make a case that he's the best free agent in the crapping class because he is amazing. Then you got Benny Logan from the Eagles. He's really good. Brandon Williams, like I said, he's really good, and he's what we need. We don't need a pass rusher. We need somebody who's very good. I'm talking, when I say very good, I'm talking amazing. Okay, I'm talking about a brick, a boulder in the middle of that defense is what we need. Okay, I'm sick and tired of people running on us. Okay, that and a linebacker. If we got those two things, it'd be amazing. Defensive end wise, I would love to re-sign Andre Branch. I thought he had a great year. He's very high motor, and he's got all the skills to be a great defensive end in the league. He's still pretty young. They got Jabal Sheer. I don't really like Jabal Sheer. Mario Addison is very good. Calais Campbell's a 3-4 guy. He's not a 4-3 guy. And obviously, JPP. So those are the guys there. Offensive tackle is very weak. There's nothing there. There's really nothing there. Tight end is Deion Sims. Forgot about Deion Sims. We have to re-sign Deion Sims for sure. In terms of guys, there's a pretty terrible class. You got Martellus Bennett, I don't really like Martellus Bennett that much. Jack Doyle. He had a great season. Michael Rivera. He's a pretty good receiving tight end. He's kind of inconsistent though. He doesn't really put a lot of great games together. Jermaine Gresham, he's out of his crapping prime. So you got that. Wide receiver, this is not something we need to explore, but if you guys want to know, you got Terrell Pryor, some of the big names, Alshon Jeffrey, Kenny obviously is. I swear to God, we better re-sign Kenny Stills. Then you got people like DeSean Jackson. You got the DeSean Jackson, you got some pretty good, that's a pretty good class. Running back, this is not something we need to go down, but in case you guys are wondering, some of the names that headline the running back class: Le'Veon Bell, Latavius Murray, LeGarrette Blount, Eddie Lacy. Some of the guys there. Quarterback, don't even care about. Doesn't even matter. So that's about it. Let's see if I just make sure I didn't miss anything. Offensive tackle is so weak this year, guys. I mean, we got people like Mike Rimmers. And that we don't need. Nobody needs a Mike Rimmers. Let me tell you something about Mike Rimmers. He's crappy. He's so bad. He's worse than Jason Fox. That's how bad he is. Kickers. If you guys don't like Andrew Franks, you got Legatron, Greg Zuerlein, Stephen Hauschka is terrible. I don't like him. Nick Novak, Connor Barth, and Phil Dawson. Some of the guys for kickers, I guess. So yeah. And just in closing here, before I let end the video. We have to re-sign. I cannot stress enough how bad we need to re-sign Kenny Stills. We have to keep Andre Branch if we don't move on from him and get somebody like JPP, which is probably not going to happen ever in a million years. I know that's crazy, and that's never going to happen. Defensive tackle is something we have to at least explore. Obviously, the linebacker group this year, free agency-wise, is very strong. I like it a lot. I like Zach Brown. I like Michael Smith. Any of those guys are better than what we have now, for sure. Even though if you could grab two of those guys and put them on the team, that would be great. I mean, Jamie Collins, Melvin Ingram's a pass rusher. He's not a good coverage guy, but some people would fit in a 4-3. Jamie Collins, I still think he would fit very well in a 4-3. Malcolm Smith. Who else? Zach Brown. I'm forgetting somebody. I guess Dante Hightower's not leaving New England. But yeah, some of the we have to explore that. Cornerback, I love A.J. Boye. He's one of the most underrated players in the league. Same thing with Tremaine Johnson. Very underrated. He's going to command a lot of money, though, on free agency. And obviously, Poe or Brandon Williams. I love any of those guys. And the guard position. Now, I started the video off with that. I think we seriously need to look into that. I swear, we could flip that guard position pretty fast, and we wouldn't lose any kind of talent there at all. We just forget Jamon Bushrod. Get Zeitler, Warmack, I forget the other guy right now, I can't remember, but yeah, either one of those three guards, they're very, very good, so, yeah, so that is going to be it, guys. I'm SkyX1083, it's a lot to think about. It's a super stressful offseason. It's so stressful, because we can mess this up so easily, so yeah, that is going to be it, guys. I'm SkyX1083, and I will see you guys in the next one.